This is the Dollemore Daily, and I'm Jesse Dollemore. Well, the Trump administration and Interior Secretary Ryan Zinke have conspired against the American people in Puerto Rico, as well as the remainder of us in the country, to enrichen a personal friend and neighbor who owns Whitefish Energy. That we've already talked about. However, the plot is thickening, and it's not looking good. Not looking good for Donald Trump or Ryan Zinke, who looks like he'll be forced to quit in shame following the lead of his former colleague, Tom Price, the disgraced former Health and Human Services Secretary, which would make the ever-evaporating cabinet of Donald Trump even smaller and even less credible. The sinister, attempted-to-be-kept secret plot thickens now, though, as the actual contract giving Whitefish Energy the job has been made public. There are many disturbing aspects of this deal, but one major alarm bell is this portion of the agreement, which states, quote, "In no event shall the Puerto Rico Electric Power Authority, or PREPA, the Commonwealth of Puerto Rico, the FEMA Administrator, the Comptroller General of the United States, or any of their authorized representatives have the right to audit or review the cost and profit elements of labor rates specified herein," unquote. What? A no-bid contract worth almost of a third of $1 billion is served on a silver platter to a two-person company, and they have it written in that the very government paying for the work can't look at the books to ensure that everything is on the up and up? I don't know about you, but this smells like a couple of scammers who found their dream mark, the ultimate gullible rube. And it's now being revealed that FEMA is even saying they had nothing to do with the gifting of this contract, and congressional oversight committees are gearing up to get to the bottom of this. Which is nice, especially after Whitefish Energy was threatening the mayor of San Juan on Twitter to stop all work after this entire scam was revealed and people started asking questions. That's right, Andy Techmansky, you may be the CEO of only a two-person company, but you're in the big leagues now, brother, and you've got some explaining to do. We, the people, expect our government to be good stewards of our tax dollars, and giving $300 million no-bid contracts to rip-off artists whose only apparent qualification is being friends and neighbors of the already questionable Interior Secretary doesn't qualify. Hey, everybody. Thank you so much for checking out my channel and this video. If you like what I do here and you appreciate it, go ahead and click subscribe. And if you really like it and appreciate what I do and you'd like to join my Patreon family, there's another link there for that. It's not just for the podcast. It's also for YouTube. Thanks a lot.